Hi, and welcome to the Bible Tribe with Seeing Deep Ministries, where we see deep in a shallow world and overcome the battles of the mind with the Word of God. When we have grown up in the culture we have, we can grow accustomed to how things are supposed to be and how we should respond, and we can lose our passion. So it is in Christ. We can adapt to the Christian culture and become religious, losing the passion we should have for Christ, who died for us. The Bible reading today is from Romans chapters 11 through 12, and the verse of the day is Romans 12, verse 11. Never be lacking in zeal, but keep your spiritual fervor, serving the Lord. Sometimes we can grow lackluster in our faith when we forget what God accomplished on our behalf. But this verse is such a reminder of how we are to be. In context, Paul is speaking to us about being dedicated and faithful to God in light of who God is and what He has done on our behalf. God's people should be zealous for Him. But what does that mean? Key words today, the Greek word for zeal is spude, and it means speed, eagerness, earnestness, carefulness, diligence, enthusiasm, haste, in essence, to give our very best. One of my favorite movie scenes is such a good picture of what it means to give our very best. In a scene from Facing the Giants, in which the coach is trying to get his team to stop being apathetic and to give their very best, the only way he could get the leader of the team to give his very best was to blindfold him and urge him to keep going as he did the death crawl with another player on his back all the way to the other end zone. Sometimes we need to blindfold ourselves from the distractions of this world that chip away at our zeal for God. There's a good zeal and a bad zeal, right? Misguided or hasty zeal without making sure we understand can cause a lot of damage. Proverbs 19 verse 2 says, "Even zeal is not good without knowledge, and the one who acts hastily sins." In the beginning of Romans 12 are some of my favorite verses that remind us what should be our response, given God's incredible grace and salvation. Therefore, I urge you, brothers and sisters, by the mercies of God, to present your bodies as a living and holy sacrifice acceptable to God, which is your spiritual service of worship. And do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, so that you may prove what the will of God is, that which is good and acceptable and perfect. This, my friends, is how our passion and zeal should affect us. Our lives should be centered around God and His Word. We should be a living sacrifice. This means we're going to be kingdom-minded, living with renewed minds for His will, not ours. As our verse for the day says, never be lacking in zeal, but keep your spiritual fervor serving the Lord. Thought of the day, give your very best. God deserves nothing less. Application, we have the cure for spiritual cancer. Let's act like it. We keep our spiritual fervor when we keep focused on God and His Word. Go with God and His precious Word, friends. Tune in tomorrow as we head back into the book of Genesis.